take you now to James Wilson, who's been talking to people who've witnessed much of what's unfolded there. James, what do we know?
Well, Mark, it's one of those points, I guess, to make that in the digital age of 2024, a lot of what's happened inside the shopping centre has been captured on mobile phone and photos. I have seen some of those videos and seen some of those photos, and what I've witnessed is truly horrific. We've seen multiple people injured. We've also seen photos of people, including this attacker with a knife, lying in a pool of blood on level 4 of this shopping centre. As we brought you earlier in this coverage, Jason, he witnessed the moment that this man with a knife was shot dead by a single female police officer. The pandemonium that he described of people running in all sorts of directions into shops and towards exits was reflected in some of the videos I've just seen myself. And of course, that moment when the attacker came face to face with the police officer, that has also been captured on video as well. At the moment, this is still very much a spectacle. And as we brought you a little bit earlier, concerned loved ones who know that their family members have been trapped inside have been coming down asking for information. It does feel like at this point, Mark, we are getting to a point of this operation where most, if not all, people have been vacated from the shopping centre. But even still, as we go to air, we've seen individuals slowly but surely trickle out and being shepherded and escorted by police. Just up here, underneath the bridge connecting the Westfields, Mark, that has been somewhat of a triage centre the entire time. A row of stretchers awaiting or ready to go for people who've been injured in this stabbing frenzy at Bondi Junction. The amount of people being treated and taken out has slowed down, but you can see, just as we go to air, these two police officers walking across the road, heavily armed tactical police. That is what we're dealing with here, and Polair flying above. They are still patrolling. It feels like at the moment maybe they're not as on high alert as they once were when there was this rush of energy and intensity. It feels like they may have the situation in hand, but that police presence, Mark, has not wavered, and no one will be leaving here anytime soon.
James, just quickly, do you get the sense there that there are still heavily armed tactical police inside the centre, ensuring that another attacker could be hiding inside? Or is it too hard for you to say?
Most definitely, Mark. Well, most definitely. It's even since we've been here, we've seen through the windows, the bridge connecting the two shopping centres, we've seen heavily armed police with those machine guns that we showed you earlier going from floor to floor, sweeping the shopping centre, something you would see in the movies, in a blockbuster movie, sweeping the shopping centre floor by floor, shop by shop. They need to check every single nook and cranny of this shopping centre so they can be confident that there are no more active attackers still left in there. Police are at every single exit and entry to this building, and officers are very much still inside. I did just see as well a number of detectives arrive and start making their way into the building, which would suggest they're now entering somewhat of a new phase of this investigation. But of course, the details here are very scant and pedantic as well. People are still trying to come to terms with what's happened. And of course, as soon as we get that confirmed information, we will keep you up to date.
OK, James, thank you. We think you should tell you that at 5:45 this evening, the police will hold a press conference detailing what they know, what has unfolded here. What we can tell you that we believe that up to or at least 6 people have either been stabbed or shot inside the Bondi Junction at Westfield Centre. This occurred actually on multiple levels. And as you can imagine, it's been an incredible Saturday afternoon here in Sydney. There were many thousands of people in this area. And when the shooting started, people were hiding in various shops. Some shop owners locked the doors, got people in and held them to safety until they could see police were getting the upper hand. Now, we do understand at this stage that a man, he's been described as the attacker, has been shot. We are unsure of his condition. We're going to take you now back to Madison Scott, who is on the street there. She just spoke to a couple of gentlemen who actually stepped in to try to help 2 people who were injured, including a mother and a baby. Madison, what more do we know?
Yeah, look, Mark, as we just saw those two men walk out of these doors here at Westfield, this section here has been a constant trickle of people being let out in waves from particular shops and particular little nooks and crannies where people have been hiding anywhere they could when that alarm was sounded this afternoon. Now, we have a row of people, a group of people here behind me who are still waiting for loved ones, Mark. Some have lost reception or lost connection with their loved ones, but have been getting different messages here and there of, yes, I'm okay, or, you know, the calls of goodbyes even. We heard from one daughter before who was concerned about her mother inside. Now, this is Emma. Emma, your dad and granddad are still inside. How are they going?
As far as I know, they're fine, but yeah, there's not really much reception to get a hold of them. So,
and what was going through your mind this afternoon?
A lot of scared, confusion, concern, terrified, bit of everything.
But at least now you know that they're okay, they're just still inside.
Yeah, so a bit relieved, but still concerned for everyone else.
I can imagine. So we are hearing so many stories like Emma's of people waiting here, waiting for their loved ones. But just moments earlier, there was a group of girls that were standing here, and one of the they said, we're waiting for our friend, we need to take her to the hospital. Then a young lady with a stab wound on her arm and a quite a large bandage on her arm walked shell-shocked out of this Westfield. Her friends then took her hand in hand and took her to one of the ambulances. We can see now here on the road, the ambulances are absolutely lined up right from down there all the way to the back end of Oxford Street. So it's almost like a taxi line of emergency services on standby. We've also got Polair just coming up above us. They have been going all afternoon surveying the area, and we've just got the tactical squad just driving in here behind me. Those police are heavily armed and have been coming and going in and out of this Westfield all afternoon. So more emergency services are still arriving. So it's very much an unfolding situation. And as you said, Mark, we will know more when police talk to us in a press conference later this afternoon.
OK, Madison, thank you for that. We will come back to you. I want to bring in now my colleague, which is, it's absolutely incredible what we're watching here. But Deb, you've seen these pictures come in now. I don't think in 3 decades I've seen anything like it.
These are extraordinary scenes, Mark. And this is obviously a very busy shopping centre at the start of school holidays in New South Wales. Mm. So we have got a lot of families who are gathering at this Westfield shopping centre on a beautiful fine day in Sydney. Mm. Lots of families gathering, and we're hearing from a lot of the people who are shocked as they're being evacuated from the area, having to be in lockdown as the tactical operations unit swept in. And it's still an active scene, of course, and many very panicked families, very panicked loved ones wanting to know what is happening with their family members. And it's still unfolding as we speak. But these are just extraordinary scenes that are unfolding. This is a hugely busy shopping precinct, Westfield, in Bondi Junction in Sydney, where we have so many people gathering to do their shopping, to go to the gym, to go gather with their friends as they do on a Saturday afternoon. So it's just, you know, as we see, shock and real dismay unfolding.
I think too, Deb, that shot that Madison just showed you of people still anxious, waiting for more news. I really worry about those people. I mean, they haven't heard if they've got relatives in there, what their condition is. Have they been taken to hospital? You know, it's a very upsetting scene to look at those people standing outside.
And that sense of uncertainty of not knowing whether or not the attacker has actually been contained. We'll hear from police. They'll be holding a press conference shortly at 5:45 p.m. We'll hear directly from police with an update of the situation. We'll bring that to you as it happens. But it is just extraordinary scenes. And the police operation, Polair in the skies, trying to get a sense of still what is unfolding, and people wanting answers as to what has occurred for their loved ones who have still been locked down inside this centre as we speak.